Everybody ready to go?
Sure.
We're ready. We just have to get there.
I'm going to get a thumbs up from Alice right away.
There's Alice.
Okay, good morning, everyone. Almost like the teacher in me, I almost feel like having that light switch in the corner of the room and shutting it off and on, and then gets everybody's attention. So we could do the whole, but we don't have to because you guys all listen quite well right off the bat. So good morning and welcome to the great community of Headingley this morning. As you can tell, we've ordered some blue skies and some nice warm weather for this incredible announcement today. I'd like to start off by acknowledging that we here in Manitoba reside on Treaties 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 10, and of course the traditional territories of the Anishinaabe, Cree, Ojibwe Cree, Inuit, Dakota, Dene, and of course the homeland of the Red River Métis. I am Wayne Ewasko, I'm the Minister of Education and Early Childhood Learning, and I'm thrilled to be your MC today. We are joined today by Premier Heather Stefanson, MP for Winnipeg North, Mr. Kevin Lamoureux. We have Jim Robson, His Worship, the RM of Headingley. And we have Justin Bova, President, Pretium Projects, and Lori Renton, who's the Executive Director of Bright Beginnings. I'd like to thank and welcome all the municipal reps that have joined us today for this incredible announcement. I see Colleen Sklar here as well, who's representing the Capital Region and has done a lot of work with us in regards to government. Also, I would absolutely be remiss and they would heckle and throw something at me if I didn't mention them. My good friends and colleagues who are sitting in the front row. We've got Minister of Seniors and Long-Term Care, Minister Johnson. We have Minister Greg Nesbitt, Natural Resources and Northern Development, sorry. And we've got Bob Legacy, MLA for Dawson Trail, have joined us as well. So many of you have been following the news the last few days and the last few months and the last year and a half, or if not more. Manitoba is the leader in the country in implementing affordable, high-quality early learning and childcare, and continues to make accessible, affordable, high-quality childcare for families a major priority right here in our great province of ours. We have made great strides in expanding affordable childcare options to families and will continue our investment in growing and strengthening the early learning and childcare sector. Right now, I would like to call upon our Premier, Heather Stefanson, to make today's announcement.
Well, thank you very much, Minister Ewasko. Great to be here along with our colleagues from the Manitoba Legislature, our colleagues from the federal government, from this beautiful municipality, the RM of Headingley. Mr. Mayor, great to be here with you and Justin and Lori for this really, really exciting announcement today. It was hard to believe that it was just in November when we were out announcing, you know, the first of this. And here we are today with it actually have been built and opening. I think, Lori, you're going to announce when it's opening, I think, but fairly soon. And so this is really, really exciting. And I'm so honored to be here with all of these incredible individuals today and all of you. I think just the fact that there's this many people here today is indicative of how important childcare is in all of our communities. And so it's just an honor to be here with all of you today. Our government, as Minister Ewasko mentioned, is one of the first in Canada to sign on an agreement to make $10 a day childcare a reality. And we are leading the country with our agreement with the federal government. Since 2020, we have opened and committed to or funded nearly 12,000 childcare spaces. We have committed to 23,000 childcare spaces by 2026. So you can see we're almost halfway there. This is very exciting. So these real results are helping more Manitoba parents make ends meet and giving them more ability to participate in the workforce and to pursue education. Our PC team is fighting to ensure that all families have access to affordable and high quality childcare, regardless of where they live in this beautiful province of ours. It was only last November, as I mentioned, that we announced that 9 new childcare facilities would be opening in rural and Indigenous communities in Manitoba. This helps ensure that families in rural Manitoba will soon have better access to quality and affordable childcare. The facilities are being built as ready-to-move childcare sites. It's an innovative and cost-effective way to create more childcare spaces sooner. Today, we're here to celebrate the first of these sites opening this summer. This is a game changer in childcare space expansions to meet rising needs for rural Manitoba. And I'm thrilled to announce the town of St. Anne and the RM of Wallace Woodworth will be the next 2 RMs to receive new ready-to-move childcare centers. So when complete, both phases of this project will create 1,970 new childcare spaces in 25 rural and First Nation communities right across Manitoba. I think we've heard loud and clear from parents that we need more childcare spaces, and our PC team is fighting to create thousands of new spots for all of our children. Affordable and accessible childcare helps families make ends meet and makes our communities stronger. So once again, I'm just so incredibly honored to be a part of this with all of these incredible individuals and all of you who have really been integral in making this exciting announcement happen today. Thank you. Have a great day.
We'll leave that there. Oh, thank you very much, Premier Stefanson, for those words and that incredible, incredible announcement. And congratulations to the 2 additional centers that we've now announced this morning. I'd like to now call upon MP Mr. Kevin Lamoureux to bring a few words on behalf of the federal government.
Thank you, Wayne, and what a pleasure it is. Good morning, one and all. And, you know, there's a few thoughts that maybe I could share, you know, picking up on what our Premier said, and just to thank her for the participation. Rob, as our mayor, Lori, as the executive director, really appreciate the opportunity to be here on such a beautiful day to talk about such an important issue. A number of years ago, we had made the determination that we need to move forward in a very proactive way with the issue of childcare. It was a commitment that we had made and literally put aside billions of dollars in order to turn it into a reality. The province of Manitoba, with the leadership of Premier Heather Stefanson, has really made a difference. As she has pointed out, accurately so, Manitoba in many ways has been leading the way. Modeled after the province of Quebec, where we have seen the immense benefit by bringing in a national child care learning program, we know and understand and we will realize the benefits that go far beyond even the provision of child care. So it's with great pleasure that I'm here. Wayne, thank you for the land acknowledgement. We are creating a system that was never just about reducing child care fees. It is, in fact, about growing the economy and so much more. And it is nice to be sharing the stage with the special guests today. That is why we have been saying childcare is a necessity. That is why we took the big step of making historic investments of $30 billion over 5 years to build a Canada-wide system with provincial, territorial, and Indigenous partnerships. It has been quite the journey. Since the signing of early learning and child care agreements on August the 9th, 2021, Manitoba, Saskatchewan, Newfoundland, and Labrador, and Nunavut have all achieved the goal of $10 a day licensed child care, 3 years ahead of the national target. Prior to signing their agreements, Quebec and the Yukon were already providing childcare for $10 a day or less. And Alberta, British Columbia, New Brunswick, Northwest Territories, Nova Scotia, Ontario, and Prince Edward Islands, those fees for licensed child cares have decreased by at least 50%. They're all working towards the $10 mark. We know finding child care space has long been a struggle. From the start, the Government of Canada has made it clear that expanding the number of regulated and affordable spaces would be the key to the success of the system. Manitoba has committed to creating 23,000 new full-time regulated care spaces by March 2026. And there's no doubt in my mind that Manitoba will continue to lead the way and demonstrate its goal by achieving that $23,000 mark. Less than 1 year ago, we celebrated Minister Ewasko's announcement to move forward with capital funding to help develop the Ready to Move childcare pilot project. The goal of the project, as supported by the provincial and federal governments, was to enable the construction of childcare facilities in the areas with demonstrated childcare needs. We all knew it would be a crucial step forward for higher communication here in Manitoba. As Minister Ewasko said at the time, rural and Indigenous communities across the province have a significant need for access to high quality and culturally appropriate child care services. Canada and Manitoba have now provided more than $94 million for two phases of the Ready to Move Child Care project. It's an innovative investment that will ultimately help us create those 2,000 new child care spaces in 20 rural and 3 First Nation communities across the province. Today, we're celebrating the opening of the first of many spaces to come. Premier Stefanson says that this is a game changer, and I certainly agree. Our collaboration on this project has been a tremendously effective and cost-effective way to create a large number of child care spaces in a short amount of time. The federal government is committed to continue to work with our partners in Manitoba, as it is a critical as the program continues to grow and mature. Again, we thank you for coming out today for what we believe is an incredible announcement, because we love our children. Thank you.
Thank you, Kevin, for those words, and I would like to now invite His Worship Jim Robson to say a few words on behalf of Headingley. Jim?
Thank you. Well, good morning, everyone, and thanks for attending this announcement. I mean, as you can see, it's another beautiful sunny day in Headingley, so as usually is, I mean, that's...
Absolutely.
Well, as mayor, I'm very grateful to have this facility in our community, but I should also add that I have another role, and that's as executive member of the JohnQ Public and JohnQ Build organization. And I just wanted to give you a bit of a background on that, because in 2018, our 13 municipalities across the Winnipeg metropolitan region developed a platform to promote collaborative approach to community development. And JohnQ Build, the daycare pilot project, is a result of that collaboration. JohnQ Build provides a platform to create created a team of leaders, CAOs, public works staff, planning staff, provincial experts, builders, trades, architects, and daycare providers who have rolled up their sleeves to build and to expedite this process. I should say, back in November, when I was first approached by the builder that they were going to have this facility open this summer, I had zero confidence that it was going to happen. So I got to admit, I was wrong. I think the key to success has really been collaboration and cooperation. And that's one of the things I just wanted to also talk about, is that, you know, we've developed a trail to create a process for more communities, large, small, rural, urban, and northern, that can follow to get more essential daycare spaces built faster and effectively. So today's announcement is not only about the opening of this beautiful daycare and others across the region, but it also is proposing that collaboration is a way to proceed. on behalf of the myself and JohnQ Build team, I would like to thank Mr. Lamoureux and the Canadian government for their contribution. I certainly would like to thank Premier Stefanson and Minister Ewasko for their leadership, their vision, and active support of this pilot project that we are here today to deliver this important infrastructure to our community. So thank you very much. Thank you very much. I can personally state that the completion of this daycare facility in Headingley will go a long way to address the significant need for daycare spaces in our community. And I think Lori's going to speak to that a bit maybe later, and it's certainly something we've been looking forward to. But before I close, I'd like to acknowledge all the partners that are involved from a municipality point of view and from our others in the JohnQ Build project, and many of them are here today. Reeve Brad Erb and CEO Daryl Horachuk and of the RM McDonald. We've got Mayor Chris Ewing and Mitch Duval from the RM of Reshot. We've got Mayor Sandra Smith and CEO Wally Melanchuk from the town of Stonewall, Mayor Debbie Feeblecorn and CEO Deepak Joshi from the RM of St. Clement. And we have Councillor Roy Tufford and the CEO Kyle Hamilton from the RM of Portage of Prairie, and Mayor Knox and the CEO Nathan Petto from the City of Portage, Reeve West Taplin and CEO Chris Lehman from the RM of Rockwood, Mayor Armin Poirier and CEO Christine Hutlett from the RM of Taché, and Reeve Brad Sulek and CEO Shelley Mowat from the RM of Brokenhead, and Chief Dr. Stan Bird, and the Peguis First Nation Real Estate Trust, and Reeve Walter Amarangan from, did I get it right? Walter. Sorry, Walter. and Colleen Johnson from the RM of Whitemouth, and Reeve Scott Siemens and Larry, and CEO Larry Dreger from the RM of Morris, and not least is our CAO Sandra Miller from the RM of Headingley. Again, thank you for joining all of us today and those of you who have worked so hard on supporting this project. And thank you, Premier Stefanson, for your leadership. We do appreciate it, and it's nice to see tangible results that we can really put to use very soon. Thank you.
Excellent. Thanks very much.
Thank you. Mayor Robson, and as you can see, the beautiful building and everything's pretty much ready to go, and we've got a couple more speakers and to bring a little bit more detail to how this whole process went, I'm going to call upon Justin Bova to bring forward a few words. Justin.
Madam Premier, Minister Ewasko, MP Lamoureux, Mayor Robson, our operator, Lori Renton, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Justin Bova, and I'm the president of Pretium Projects Limited, Manitoba's first lean construction specialist and the selected design builder for the JQ Built Daycare pilot projects. Collaboration, and several of the speakers have mentioned that word already, you know, is a word that's thrown around pretty loosely these days. One could even argue that it's become a buzzword of sorts, where people talk about it, but they really don't know what it means. Well, I'm here to tell you that this beautiful, innovative, and welcoming space behind me is indeed the result of true collaboration. Collaboration with our owner, JQ Built, Colleen Sklar, Joe Liuzzi, and their amazing team for their vision and boldness in creating this JQ vehicle to meet the considerable childcare needs in many of our rural and northern communities. Collaboration with ELCC, Pam Weaver, Lily Mallard, and Janelle Blakey, their operators and end users that provided incredible input, not only during the design development phase, but throughout the construction process. Collaboration with the First Nations, townships, cities, RMs, their CAOs, building inspectors and plan examiners. Thank you for working with us and challenging us. I feel these synergies provided a greater end product. Collaboration with our tremendous design team, Chagas Architecture, Indigo Arrows, Sequence Design, Wolfram Engineering, SMS Engineering, Spearman Landscaping, Sandbox Consulting, Diagrove Robinson, and Crozier Kilgore & Partners for not only their creativity and vision, but for also producing issued for construction drawings within a two-month period, without cutting corners or without reducing the quality of the documents. Collaboration with our trade and supply partners, whom we worked with closely to ensure the supply chain was controlled while providing sufficient labor forces to better the contemplated construction schedule of 8 months to just under 5 months. Collaboration with my fellow Pretium team members, our estimators. They're the good-looking bunch in the corner wearing the high-vis gear. Our estimators, coordinators, safety officers, project managers, and project superintendents, building 10 of these facilities across southern Manitoba concurrently is no small task. I'd like to specifically acknowledge our Director of Child Care Projects, Mr. Jofiel Ronquillo, who has really championed every facet of these projects on behalf of our team. This true collaboration has resulted in a design that exceeds all Manitoba childcare guidelines while incorporating real-world applications of the operators and end users that know what it takes to run these facilities every day. A proprietary prefabricated building system that can be installed in 2 days, fully watertight with windows and roofing within a week, and can be replicated anywhere in the province. A building constructed to the highest QAQC standards with every major component independently tested, inspected, and verified by third-party consultants. An all-electric building that betters the Manitoba Energy Code for buildings by a massive 27%, ensuring an ultra-energy efficient facility with a reduced carbon footprint. A truly Manitoba project, created, designed, manufactured, and constructed with material, labor, and management from right here in our province. Finally, a design that acknowledges our collective role in truth and reconciliation with Indigenous and First Nations people, incorporating a star blanket design unique to the history of that specific geographical location. The star blanket behind me is Prairie Meadow. Is the Prairie Meadow design created by the great Destiny Seymour, one of our interior designers. As lean construction specialists, we are in a never-ending mission to perfect the process flow, to add value, mitigate risk, eliminate waste, and to pass on those savings and improved quality to the project. On behalf of our design build team, I would like to thank Premier Stefanson and the province for their investment and support of this innovative approach to childcare that will have positive and lasting impacts to the families of in the arm of Headingley and to all the communities we serve. Thank you.
Thank you, Justin, very much for those words and a little bit of a sneak peek into the process of how this wonderful building came to fruition today. At this time, I would like to call upon Executive Director Lori Renton of Bright Beginnings to share a few words with us as well. Thanks, Lori.
Good morning, everyone, and thank you for coming out. On behalf of Bright Beginnings, our board, our staff, and myself, I would like to share how grateful and pleased we are to be a part of this exciting opportunity that has been provided to us. We are fortunate that we are able to provide support to more families in our area and welcoming them into our BBE family and circle of care. We currently have almost 500 people on our wait list, and we are happy that we'll be able to support some more in our area. We are looking forward to creating new relationships with children and providing them with a safe, respectful, and inclusive environment that honors each child's individuality and amazing self. The activities and programs that will be offered are nature-based, helping us to create a sense of peace and calm with the children, and they will be invited to play and participate in well-rounded and rich opportunities that are full of curiosity, discovery, learning, and most importantly, fun. I would also like to share that there can never be enough acknowledgement and appreciation for our staff. They are enthusiastic, loyal, passionate, dedicated, and we are looking forward to having others join our team. Daily, we are surrounded by children's laughter, tears, stories, and hugs, and we are reminded what an honor and a privilege it is to be a part of their life journey. I would like to thank the federal and provincial government, the Honorable Heather Stefanson, Premier of Manitoba, Minister Wayne Ewasko, the RM Headingley and Council, and all of the many folks, which is all of you, behind the scenes, who have believed in us and helped us grow to arrive at this day. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you very much, Lori. And thanks to your support, families across the province are going to benefit. Together, and you've heard many of the speakers bring forward that collaboration word, and Justin, you know what, it does sound at times like a little bit of a buzzword, but truly, you cannot get things done like we're getting things done without that collaboration and working with our partners. So a big round of applause to everybody involved. Together, we are building a strong and resilient and accessible childcare system right here in Manitoba, and families are the ones who are going to benefit the most. These types of things can't happen alone, and as we've heard, partnerships and collaboration with Premier Stefanson and our team, the Manitoba Legislature. I am more than humbled to have a great team in the Department of Education and Early Childhood Learning, and I would like to acknowledge a few of them today as well that work extremely hard behind the scenes. I've got my Deputy Minister, Dana Rudy, here is with us. Dana, give just a wave. Sarah Whiteford, my Assistant Deputy Minister, specifically in charge of early childhood education. And then to help bring some of this together, you've heard their names already, but definitely can give them a bit of a shout out again. We have Lily Mallard and we have Pam Weaver here with us as well. And again, I want to thank Premier Heather Stefanson for her words today. Without her direction, without her leadership, things like this could not get done. And it does come with those good partnerships and collaborations with other levels of government, as you've seen here today as well. Thank you also for your words today, MP Lamoureux, Mayor Robson, Justin Bova, and of course, Lori Renton, for speaking and joining us here today. And I want to thank each and every one of you for joining us here on a nice warm day in Headingley. Thank you, merci, and Megwitch. We're going to take some questions from the media, and then we're going to get a couple photos.